Data can be presented using tables, graphic displays, and graphs. The most common kind of table is the frequency table. These can in fact be used to collect, sort, and analyze data as well as present it. The categories or groups of values can be determined in advance or written in as the data is collected based on the responses to survey questions. When used as a presentation tool, the tally marks are normally omitted. The table can be augmented with additional columns to analyze the data, for example, to calculate the mean and median. A two-way table, sometimes called a contingency table, is a way of presenting data when there are two different ways of looking at it. For example, this table shows data for the hair color of married couples. A table like this enables some sophisticated questions to be asked and answered from different perspectives. More visually, a dot plot gives a very easy to understand overview of the distribution of the data. Dot plots can be used for numerical or categorical data. A stem and leaf plot also gives a visual overview of the data distribution, but still retains all the information for the individual data scores. A stem and leaf plot can be used to get a good overall impression, but it is also easy to use for position-based analysis, for example, calculating median, quartiles, and interquartile range. If you have got the median and quartile values, you can draw a box and whisker plot. This gives a really clear picture of where and how the data is distributed, although it does so by hiding specific details of individual score values. The line in the middle of the box is the median, the edges of the box are the lower and upper quartiles, and the ends of the whiskers are the minimum and maximum values in the dataset. Each section of the plot represents one quarter of the data. So half of all the scores for this plot are between 15 and 23. A quarter of the scores are between 21 and 23. In contrast, the lowest quarter of the scores are spread out between 4 and 15. And then there are graphs. Pie graphs are useful when there's some concept of a whole, when the total of all the categories is in some way the total of all possible options. Histograms are good for comparing the relative frequencies of each category or group of scores. And there are many, many other ways to draw graphs of data.